It's the first thing. It's the first link. I just wanted to make sure before I...
So right now we are setting up HolyDiver with FunkDoc. You guys donated for this as the bonus game instead of Maximum Carnage. And if you have not seen this game, you are in for a treat. And here's to hoping for no soft block. In the meantime, Mika Share donated $20. Good luck with the rest of the runs. Keep up the good work. Herbert Wu donated $40 and says, really like the Scott Pilgrim versus the World game and love what you guys are doing. Keep it up. Whoever is making those pearlers is awesome. And the donation should go towards Dark Souls glitches. Johnny Dahlberg donated $15 and says, put this towards whatever the biggest Scott Pilgrim fan wants, or the first one to claim the title.
That's me. Die Hard.
Die Hard?
Okay, if it's not that one, that's this one. Yeah, you read
it. Anthony Baker II donated $5 and says, I want a pearler. This is for Murphigator's Double Dragon Neon Run. Wait, it's not on the schedule? Well, I guess I'll put it towards the true ending for Contra Shattered Soldier and stop Scott Pilgrim, guys. Terra Affirmative.
It's the game breaking up.
I'm going to push real hard to get that into bonus stream, Double Dragon Neon.
Oh, yeah.
Phil Greener donated $30 and says, Jordan Greenalink, both your grandfathers are watching down... Both your grandfathers are watching down on you. Love, Mom and Dad. Very proud of you. Good luck.
He just left the room.
Yes.
It was hard to read donations during your run because you guys were just being amusing.
Yeah. Where is everyone?
Oh, they'll come back. We got HolyDiver.
I know. That's why. Yeah. Why am I the only one in the chair?
Jonas Wingren donated $10 and says, good job so far. Keep it up. Looking forward to StarCraft 2 stuff. Thank you very much.
Just during the first stage, really.
Okay, you're not going to want to explain anything during the first
stage. So if I haven't said it enough times, we have HolyDiver coming up next with FunkDoc. And after that, we are going to be moving on to Earthbound.
Yeah, it's definitely stage one.
So you are watching Awesome Games Done Quick 2013, hosted by Speed Demos Archive, and also featuring many of the runners from SpeedrunsLive.com. We are teaming up together to support the Prevent Cancer Foundation with their mission to prevent cancer. Their four pillars are research, education, community outreach, and advocacy, with their mission to prevent cancer before it starts. Up to 60% of cancer cases and more than 50% of cancer deaths are preventable with the knowledge that we have right now. So let's team up and defeat cancer. All of the money that you are donating will go directly to the PCF, and we have plenty of prizes that you can win while donating during the runs, including our two grand prizes, the Wii U bundle, which is a new Wii U with, I forget the first game, and new Super Mario Brothers Wii U. Zombie U and new Super Mario Brothers it also includes two Wiimotes and nunchucks, and that is a minimum $30 total donation, as the grand prizes do allow for multiple donations adding up to the minimum amount. And we also have our other grand prize of the Gunblade made by Tom Foligno. That is a $40 donation. Once again, the two grand prizes, you can donate multiple amounts to add up to the minimum, and the most you can donate for multiple entries on the grand prizes are $100 for the Wii U and $150 for the Gunblade. It looks like we should be ready to go here any moment. What's the word?
Yeah, we're all set. So whenever Josh and I start.
Okay, I'll do
the countdown. Yeah, and FunkDoc's awesome at this, so I'm not going to have many opportunities to do the donation, so enjoy HolyDiver!
So 3, 2, 1. God bless the Dio.
All right. So Josh has asked me to read the story to this game as he plays stage one.
Resurrected, the legend of the holy magic king's justice.
It is the 666th year of the world of magic. The Black Slayer, Demon King of the Underground Dark Empire, has extended the world of darkness and weakened the power of King Crimson, whose wisdom has guided the world of magic for generations. The 16th Crimson Empire Emperor Ronnie IV entrusted his two infant sons, Randy and Zack, to his faithful servant Ozzy. The three escaped the forces from another dimension in the hope to bring the light back to the world. The next 17 years were difficult, but Randy, Zack, and Ozzy devoted themselves to the cause of holy magic justice. The Black Slayer had further extended his empire over the countryside, and the interdimensional forces were even more powerful. Randy needed to find the royal coat of arms of the Crimson to battle the demons. He set out alone to carry out the will of his surrogate father Ozzy, who had passed away. Thus begins the legend of the Holy Magic King's Justice.
There we go, just in time for the first boss. Because this is one of the harder ones, actually.
Wow,
great fight there, too. That's one of the hardest to do well for a speedrun, so really happy with that one. Here's a little glitch here. Yeah, you can jump at the start of that room when normally you're just frozen there until the wall closes. So that saves a little bit of time. So here's the deal with this game. For those who don't know, yes, the plot that you just mentioned, completely not made up. It does, in fact, reference Ronnie James Dio, Randy Rhodes, who is your player character, actually, Zach Wilde, Ozzy Osbourne, Slayer, and King Crimson. Not picking any of this up. So, there you go.
It's pretty fantastic.
Possibly. There's no possibly about it. In addition to all that, this is, I would say, quite possibly the hardest game ever for the NES. You won't really see it as much yet, but it will come into play more for Stage 3 and afterward. We'll see. And so the other thing with this game is, you notice there's a few different spells you get. You get a new spell at the end of each stage, except for Stage 5. So the one you start with is Twin Fire, which is the one I was using throughout the first stage. It's pretty simple. Just a shot that does more damage than your normal one and goes across the entire screen. And the Blizzard is also fairly self-explanatory, freezes enemies and lava required for some areas such as this. However, it only tends to work on smaller enemies. It does not work on a lot of the larger ones who are, like, the real problem most of the time. This section is hard, actually. This one jump here is tight. Made it, like...
It is very strange to see Blizzard in actual FPS. I'm used to seeing the screen flicker, like, once a second.
For those of you wondering, he's changing colors because you equip between your basic shot and the spell you have equipped. And it's just the select button, I want to say, to do that?
Yeah, select.
He's changing colors?
Not right now.
Oh, okay.
We'll take this, I guess. Okay. Still a faster fight than the TAS, believe it or not, because the TAS doesn't use Twin Fire on this boss for some reason. So there you go. You got Brains!
You got Brains!
Here we go. This is where the game starts to get real, and this is the beginning of why I say this might be the hardest NES game. Even this section has some pretty precise stuff, but you'll see a bit later on. Okay, that was bad. Although, actually, no, I should be okay. I'll get the full MP. But I freeze here, otherwise you have to wait for the tears that those eyes send down on you. Oh god, that's bad luck there. These flies take really random patterns. Use a blizzard there to make the bat to keep the bats from firing, because the bats' firing patterns are also random. As is some of the attack patterns with those flying mutated fish things. Yeah. A lot of what makes this game so hard is how random a lot of the enemies are in it, compared to, say, Ghosts and Goblins or Battletoads or something. Okay. I might be able to make this work. Oh my god, I can't believe this if I'm gonna get it. Yes, okay. I mean, at least I didn't die there. That room is horrible.
Yeah, guys, we're aware of what's going on IRC, and we're working on it. So just give us a few minutes, okay?
So I could... There are better ways to handle that section, but at least I didn't die. Also, those bouncing Chia Pet scorpions are the worst. Their firing patterns, again, are completely random, and they're almost like shmup bullet patterns, which makes sense since this game was made by Irem, who's probably best known for R-Type.
Irem has such a weird variety of games.
Yeah, I mean, they did this, Metal Storm, God knows what else.
Kickle Cubicle.
They made Kickle Cubicle, really?
I believe so.
I'm just praying for health drop here. Of course it's not gonna happen, though. Although, he's giving me a good pattern at least. No! I say that. And then, yeah. Oh my god, yeah. I kind of have to take a death there, unfortunately. His pattern is just being too crappy for me. Okay.
I like the free life under the lava.
Yes. Although the thing is, lava actually doesn't kill you in this. By the way, if there's enough bolts on screen, this heart container here can randomly despawn sometimes. Also, the one-up that I got back in stage 2. How this game handles it is if there's too many sprites on the screen, it just chooses a random object to despawn, which can be an enemy or a power-up. Alright, here's a boss! That was a boss.
Nice boss.
So this is the power of Breaker here, the spell we got after stage 2. If you hit an enemy with it point blank, it does far more damage than anything else in the game. And then even just in general, it's really strong too.
What do you mean, break?
Yes. Thanks for the correction. So here we go, stage 4. This is, I think, the worst stage in the game. I'm gonna go for this. But yeah, you got these guys shooting fireballs from above in random patterns as you're dealing with all these pets. Did I do it? Of course not. That's the thing, you have to hit this one pixel jump, and you'll get damage boosted forward by one of those mutant cats. And it'll get you through that next section. But I'm gonna stick with the safer strats now. Oh god. Here we go, safe stress now. Oh my god. Another fun thing about this game, if you get damage boosted by an enemy, if you run into a wall or anything like that, your forward momentum is completely stopped, and you just drop straight down from there. Oh yes, we despawned the bouncing robot head. Good. See, these guys. There's supposed to be one of them in the previous room too, who's really annoying to deal with, because they're just like the bouncing Chia Pet scorpions. Their firing patterns are completely random, and they just fill the screen with all kinds of crap.
Enemy names are too strong.
Yes. This section here now, there we go, I got the full health drop. See, some of the drops in this game are random, but the really important ones aren't. Like, the smaller health and magic drops, those are random, but the full health and magic drops are actually fixed, and always come from the same enemies.
Oh,
they have
to do one nice thing.
Indeed. Point blank breaker, that's what I was talking about earlier. It's the death on a lot of things.
Alright, so IRC should be working again, guys. You should be able to rejoin. Sorry about that.
I don't think you mentioned it earlier. The white feathers of your MP powered up for max MP.
Yes. The wings, I guess those are supposed to be. Those are like a max MP up kind of thing. Yeah, it's tricky to fight this guy. I think I'll just... Maybe I'll just stick with normal firing since that's actually pretty good. Okay, see, our health is now just barely good enough at this point to get through the next room, even with bad patterns. And yes, now we get to turn into the dragon. You'll be seeing this a couple more times over the course of the game where it's required. Also, I didn't realize this until recently, but the dragon actually moves a little bit faster than your usual Randy Rhodes.
I like how he also sprite overloads the life bar.
Yes. Good catch. Oh god. Okay, no, we're good. Okay, never mind, we're not good. Okay, at least you made it through.
Ooh.
Yeah, that room sucks. I'm supposed to damage boost by using some fireballs from the previous golem to go through that one, but yeah, it doesn't work out that way. It's not always the most reliable thing. Also, I'm probably gonna die in this boss now, most likely. Yeah, this is by far the worst part of the entire game here, because in order to beat this thing, you have to use overdrive. Like, that's your only remotely fast option. Yeah, and then the thing is, when you use overdrive, it sprite overloads so that you can't even see a lot of the boss's shots.
Yeah, we can see it on his head.
Well, that's what I mean.
We can't see at all. Boss could also just fire two bullets in such a way that you're gonna get knocked back into the pit.
Yes, that is that too. Although we might do it. Okay. Now I gotta be careful here. Because I took out two of the sections, so that gets rid of the worst part of the boss. Whew! I was on my last life, so... I was really scared of this being to continue. There we go, now we got the ultimate magic, Thunder, which I end up using the least out of any of the spells. It still gets in there a little bit, though. And yes, one more obligatory dragon cutscene here.
Thunder would be more useful if it also got the half MP.
Yes, that's the thing, too, is that I never explained this, but... If you remember, back in Stage 4, I took a slight detour to pick up this staff. That reduces the cost for MP of all your spells by half. With the exception of Thunder. Thunder is always 20, regardless. But, like, Overdrive goes from 16 to 8, which is a huge deal, obviously. Since that's a really good spell in general. Shoutouts to Spinning Rowdy Shields. Hell yeah, look at him spazzing out. He just broke out of jail, though. He wasn't supposed to do that. Taking the safe way through this part. Because you can lose a lot of time here if you get knocked down into the lower route. You also have to make a one-pixel jump as part of that lower route. This manipulates that snake thing to act the way he does so you can get the dragon that way every time. There's a slightly faster way, but it's really hard. I'm not going to go for it here. I just have to make it through the next room because there's a 1-up. And then I should be good from there. This boss, the boss of this stage is pretty rough too, so I have to be careful. Well, never mind. So actually, as far as spots to have to die and continue go, that wasn't a bad one necessarily. Because it was still fairly early in the stage, there's a lot more to go after that. Like I'm saying, quite possibly the hardest game on the NES. I would say it is, it definitely is. Like, this is the game that Battletoads wants to be when it grows up. Oh yeah, another fun thing I didn't mention, the controls in this game can be really, really wonky in ways that can easily kill you if you're not used to it. Specifically, if you, like, press, if you tap a direction and a button at the same time, the button won't come out. So, you have to kind of, like, start moving forward first, and then jump, if you want to successfully get your jump out. So, really awkward to get used to. Oh, there we go, now I get it. Okay. So there we go. Need the dragon here so we can pick up more max MP items. Wait, on platforms that I can't even see because of the TV.
There's like a pixel there.
This room is really tricky when you're playing normally. I just have some damage boost for this. But yeah, those statue things take forever to kill normally, which is why I need the boost. This one, you can't walk forward too far, or else you'll spawn the dragon too early. Wow, can't believe I got a good pattern there. Wow, there again. This is, like, pretty much the best room you can possibly get here. Here we go with some glitch jumps now. Oh my god, now this is getting scary. Yeah, because this is what happens when you miss your clip here. Oh god. Okay. There we go, we got it. Okay. Going back here to get full health from that enemy. And we got a good luck here for the boost. This room is horrible if you're playing normally. And even now when I speedrun it, it can be pretty annoying. Oh my god. Oh, yeah. That guy, you can just walk right in by him. One last MP max, and we're getting close to the boss now. There we go. I absolutely need full health for this boss. That is a must. Now time to actually start using Thunder. Because it does more damage than Breaker if you hit him with the lightning bolt directly. Alright, now we should be good. There we go. Oh, one hit short. Oh well. And now time for a Zach Wild on a cross. Yes indeed, that is literally who that is. And da-da-da. Fusion! Ha! There we go. Yes. Fusion dance with Zach Wild on the cross. Yeah, I wonder why this game never came out in America. It actually was planned at one point. There was a preview for it in one of the big magazines. Now I have to do a really tricky damage boost because there's two different routes through this stage. Too far. Oh no, I got it! Good.
Nice.
This room is annoying, too, because, as I mentioned, despawns from sprite overflowing are random in this game. We'll see if we get the statue despawn. Yes, we did. Okay. Wow, that was like a really good room, actually, because there's supposed to be two sets of those weird statues that spawn, and I managed to despawn both of them, which is kind of rare. Some really tight jumps here coming up. That's one of them. Yeah, you don't have much of a window to go over those golems, but I've gotten good at it. That one I don't trust enough, so I just damage boost through him. This room is the worst if you don't know how to do what I just did there, because the spiders, like, if you kill one, like, another one will just instantly respawn right on top of you, and you're just gonna get caught in a never-ending loop of spawning spiders. There we go. Yes, the golems have a teleport ability now. Oh my god. Wow, why did he move forward like that? I've never seen that before.
Golems do a ridiculous amount of damage.
Yeah, they do three full bars of damage back in stage 4. It's half of that in this stage because when we did the fusion dance, we gained a new item. The cape, I guess it is. Or the cloak or something. That doubles your defense. That's why I'm taking a lot less damage in general in this stage. Oh god. Okay, no, we made it. Good. Just don't want to get looped.
Oh!
Oh!
Wow! Man, he's earning his pay today.
He was after ya.
This room is, like, impossible unless you use Blizzard, and then it becomes, like, the last easy room of the game. Because those flying skulls just keep coming on and respawning and flying around all over the place. Yeah, I'm not gonna deal with that. One of the few annoying enemies that Blizzard actually works on. So. Here we go. Now it's time to deal with the Grapes of Wrath. And I call them that because you just be doing, you know, working hard here, trying to make a living, getting through the satanic Venus heads and everything else, and no matter how hard you work, they can just randomly plunge you into the Great Depression. Just like that! And furthermore, with the Grapes of Wrath, much like the elements of capitalism that book criticizes, they never die. Yes, indeed, they are completely invincible. So you have that going for you, along with their completely random flight patterns. Yeah, this is, like, the other worst part of the game after the stage 4 boss, probably. He was trying again there. You can never be truly safe until they actually go off-screen. I think we only got a couple more shots from Beavis here. This one you can manipulate in the way that you do. Oh my god, I literally can't see the platform.
Oh.
Wow. At least
this
that
TV is strong.
This room is even worse than the previous one, though. Because you have to do this one pixel jump, followed by a glitch jump there. Like, you have to actually clip through the platform, but I got it perfect, which is I was not expecting. That's the hardest room in the game, execution-wise, I think. The game requires you to glitch through a platform.
Yeah.
Holy diver!
That really was a spectacular room.
So I want to get rid of the middle part here first because that's the one that spawns the spiders. Here we go. Did we not softlock? I think we didn't get it, I think. You can softlock the game on this boss really easily. But, oh, we got it! Alright. Yeah, if you finish that boss off the wrong way with thunder, generally if you kill the boss by taking off two or more parts at once with thunder, yeah, you'll likely softlock the game. You can also do it on the stage 5 boss by finishing him off with thunder sometimes. Anyway, time! Alright.
Got it. Fine, 439.
Actually not bad for the next 27. I'll take that. 125 was kind of what I was looking for this, so. I'll take that. Oh, holy diver.
Holy diver.
Alright.
All right, guys.
Enjoyed that one.
That was holy
and
diver.
Hopefully, you got to see just how ridiculous this game gets, because,
Brother
wasn't. Yeah.
And now they're both dragons.
Yes, I'll let the ending play out as we get more more of the metal references from the beginning here.
Am I good to go through some
also,
donations?
Also, probably the best music in the game.
Fuck Doc.
What's up?
Am I good to go through some donations
yes.
while the credits are rolling?
Yes.
Okay, so Jonas Wingren donated $10. Good job so far. Keep it up. Looking forward to StarCraft 2 stuff. I think I read that already. Alejandro Albarin donated $5. This marathon needs more hashtags. $5 for the OOT any percent run. Hashtag Cosmo any percent. Yuri Moreira de Freitas donated $5, donating because Greena Link is so cute and, of course, because of this awesome cause. Amazing job so far.
That's right, the other dimension. That always makes me think of that Conan cartoon where they couldn't actually have him kill people. So the sword just sent them into the other dimension. Yes.
Jacqueline Reyes donated $10 and says, "Hey guys, my first time watching this year." It also says, "I'm not a gamer, but my boyfriend directed me here. It's been fun creeping on all you all, and hello from Philadelphia." So the characters aren't displaying in the first name here, but I'm just going to guess that that's a Bjorn Granholm donated $10. If it's possible, I'd like to put this towards Double Dragon Neon being played, so Murphigator gets to play a good game in this marathon. Otherwise, put it towards Lagoon. I don't think Double Dragon Neon is a bonus game. It's possible during bonus stream.
Yeah. I'm going to try and get in for bonus stream, but, I mean, for the marathon proper, yeah, it's pretty unlikely.
Alright, well, that concludes the tale of Zach Wilde and Randy Rhoads Crimsons. Hope y'all enjoyed, and, I'll be back on Friday morning with all the old school Castlevanias, so thank you for your donations for Castlevania 4 especially, and keep them coming in for Castlevania 3 character. Go Sypha!
Has Sypha made it in a marathon yet? I don't remember.
Not AGDQ.
Ginoia donated $10 and says, "Shout out goes to the Scott Pilgrim crashing. The game is fighting back in more ways than one. Put this towards getting Cosmo to run OOT. David Tadone donated $5 and says, "Appreciate what you guys are doing. Keep on trucking." So, like we said previously, that was HolyDiver. And coming up next, we do have Earthbound. We're probably cutting off most of the stuff we can do, I think. Which names do we have to do immediately for Earthbound? We have to do Ness, all of his favorites. What?
6 hours, I actually
yeah, but we have to do all the favorites at the beginning as well, right?
Yeah.
So, and then Ness, and then file name. And the other ones are a little bit later. Oh, all of them, right.
He is Ness.
So, we're going to do a final refresh on that probably soon while we're getting this set up. So, if you want to try and affect the Earthbound donations, you have to do that literally now. Per Karlstrom donated another $15 and says, "Nice gaming, Kenny Man. Having fun watching. If I win something, you bring it home. And Kenny Man, put this $15 to what you want. Keep up the fun." I think Kenny has exited the room. We can kind of put that to the side and ask him later.